So there are two different types of bacteria involved with food. The first is food spoilage bacteria, and the second is food poisoning or pathogenic bacteria. So let's take a look at food spoilage bacteria. These are easily detectable as they make the food go off. So we are able to see it, taste it, and more commonly, able to smell it. These act as warning signs to say, do not eat this. Next are pathogenic bacteria. Tiny amounts of bacteria are able to make you very sick. These are the bacteria that we are most concerned about, as you cannot see it, taste it, or smell these bacteria. Within this broad category, there is a bacterium of each class that we are generally concerned with in the kitchen environment. This applies to both the home kitchen and a production kitchen, such as restaurants, hotel, and food service. Let's take a look at E. coli. E. coli is one of the most common food poisoning bacteria and are what we call an indicator organism. E. coli originates from our gut as well as other mammals such as cows. E. coli is a gram-negative bacteria that is naturally occurring within the environment, mostly in soil or in our gut, etc. These are not per se a pathogen, in other words, a disease-causing bacteria. E. coli does exist peacefully with humans and is an important part of our internal flora. This means the internal makeup of various bacteria in our gut that allows us to consume our food. These basically keep bad pathogens at bay. However, there are strains of E. coli that are dangerous, such as E. coli 015787, but in general, E. coli is a bacteria that should be avoided at all costs. Because E. coli mostly occurs in our gut and raw meats, it becomes an indicator of unhygienic practices that may have taken place. Two perfect examples of this are when we do not wash our hands after going to the toilet and when we do not wash our hands after handling raw meats. In fact, these are two perfect examples of two of the most common causes of food poisoning. So let's take a look at the bacteria Staphylococcus aureus. S. aureus is a bacteria that occurs naturally on the skin and nasal passages of humans. Usually, this bacteria is harmless in small numbers but can cause skin infections if numbers get too high. This bacteria is known as Staphylococcus epidermis. In food, however, Staphylococcus aureus is particularly concerning because it produces a heat-stable toxin which can cause severe food poisoning. Heat-stable meaning that the toxin can survive cooking temperatures. I'm sure you can already see why S. aureus can be an indicator organism. Because S. aureus occurs in the nasal passages and on the skin, those that are carriers, usually 10 to 15% of the world's population, antibiotic treatment is required to keep this bacteria at low infection levels. Of course, hand washing and preventing touching of the nose are key areas into preventing contamination of food. Finding this bacteria in food and/or on hands of food handlers tells us that there's been some break in the food safety pillars, and the potential for causing food poisoning increases dramatically.